7/7 of 23, 1954 hours. Here's the numbers it's running. It's probably running around 2.5 volts right now. Low duty cycle, 21, this one will pop up occasionally. It's having a time interpreting. This is channel, there's not much. There's the LEDs, I got 15 of them on there. It'll go a lot brighter and it will go a lot dimmer. Here's L3. This is the L3 down here. It's a half pound of 28 gauge. This here is the, it's a, well, L1 here, L2 here. Here, this is L2, this is L1, this is a double, this is an 8 millihenry, 8.3 millihenry double, works good. All of these work also, various configurations. I've got, well, adjustable resistors. Signal diodes in place of D2 and D1. Here's L3. There's the numbers it's kicking out. This is the L1 coil. That's the one I believe is kicking out the pulse. L2. Now it's running around 9 kilohertz, so that's where the majority of the back EMF is going to be. I believe that's down in this area. Here's a 3K. See, this here I think is all the back EMF. This is a 12K. It's 30. It goes up. I mean, it'll start falling off pretty drastically around 295 kilohertz, but it's putting it out here pretty much 119 kilohertz. That's on L1 isn't quite so much. I think this is the L1 is the trigger coil is what that is. There's 12K, 6K. See, you don't get much. It's also running at a lot lower voltage. That's a 12 up to 12K. There's 30. There's 1.2. It's basically flat. Now, if you subtract channel A from channel, or L1 from L2, you get this pattern. 10 to get something of that sort. that's L1 minus L2, which is very similar to what is coming out of L3. Now, without the probes on there, I would have one side would be hot. I could crank it up. See, I can bring it up. I don't think it's going to show up. Oh, there it is. So one side. One side is hot, but the other one isn't. Coil will occasionally, if I turn it up enough, it'll. What's about this? Okay, the extension has the unused end of it. It's trying. Right now it's kind of turned down. Now I can lower the voltage. I mean, it takes close to 3 volts at 20 or 30 microamps to turn these on. I shut it off. It does have an afterglow. That'll persist for a while. I don't know if it's trying to stay on or not. But those will stay on for a while. I've just got the one cap on there. That's the 1000 mF, 16 volt. That's what I've got on there, 16 volt. These diodes, like I said, I'm running dual signal diodes. They're good for about 100 milliamps each. But I would not run this over 3 volts. At 30 milliamps. Here's my variables. Here's the signal dials. I get them doubled up. Standard NPN, these two PNPs, I have no idea what they are. And yeah, the majority of these wires are running over here. They're still on. Oh. Now this little glow light, I don't know what that means. Still don't know what he's got it on there for. Could be a current limiter. That's LED2. Goes to the base of T2. But that's what you get when you subtract the two channels. More like the inverse of this one. That's L2. That's the one kicking out the most. But that's the numbers I'm getting. I mean, it's on. I could crank this thing down. I mean, this thing, it takes at least 3 volts at 30 microamps, 40 microamps. Right now it is pushing about 1.3 volts No, about 3/4 of a volt at 800 microamps. 3/4 of a volt, 800 microamps to light those up. You couldn't light one up with 3/4 of a volt. I've done measured these already. It's pushing close to 1 milliamp. But it's still around 3/4 of a volt. So that's an update. That's the numbers. As for that L3, I don't even know if it can interact with the other one. I found these are inductors, I believe. These are inductors. They work. Even this little iron core, it's an awfully low frequency. But it'll put something up on the screen. I found you can also connect like L1 to one of these, one half of this, L2 to another one. You can try that. See how that works out. And maybe put L3 in the middle. There's 15 LEDs. I don't know if it's ever going to run itself or not. There are systems where you put in a little and you get a lot back out. Maybe perhaps this is one of them. It says it'll take 1/4 of an amp. 1/4 of an amp. Right now I've had it running at 1.3 volts, 16 milliamps. I mean, that's a long way from 250 milliamps. I don't know if I can... got enough LEDs or if I even want to try it. I'm having a time with this system. So that's an update.